I got all this cover. You know it's coming.
All right, let's move!
Right behind you!
Not one more...
How do we know? We start yelling before there's anything there. Pull. Pull and warp, like, kind of devastate an opponent, don't they? I missed that. Pull that one. Oh my, that brute thing. Everybody on that damn brute thing. What else we got? Another cannibal? He's only got two left. There's a lot of these cannibals. Oh my god. Marauder thingy over there. They just keep on coming. I'm not charging. Now I am. Oh, air in the darkness. Who's shooting at me, man?
There comes another one of those bats.
Oh, they're all over now. I'm in the middle of all of them. That's why I don't like charging that much. There's more. Well, they keep dropping. I just popped up out of nowhere. Oh, sheesh. Where is it? Right there. Kinda takes you right off your feet, huh? We're out of ammo. Oh crap. Oh! Oh, they keep appearing back there. These guys are so annoying. They're just like teleporting down here or something. Charging, baby! Oh, you're still alive? What? I didn't even aim at him. Yeah, I think I hit him. That's so weird. armor. I mean ammo. I need ammo, so just trying to run into all the ammo I can here. We gotta get rid of this harvester. We shooting at my friends like that. Now they need help. It seems like these buttons keep moving. I'm not sure why. Alright, let's switch back to the Hurricane. Yay! Good to hear it. Cool.
This way.
Wait. I gotta get ammo and goodies. I wanna cover this whole area. We can get back up this way. And I could have hit that med kit, maybe. Well, this only goes up here. Nope. All right. No, wait. Full on this one, too? We are. So we ran out of ammo, but we get ammo quicker. I figured I'd have to grab everything. Still getting used to this game versus Mass Effect 2, believe it or not. Oh, here we go. Oh, he's dead, man. There's nothing that can be done for him.
Commander Shepard, my men and I are in your debt.
No problem, Invictus. Oh, nice job.
Thank you for saving so many.
Oh, very cat-like.
What happened here?
He screwed up.
Oops.
Stand down, soldier. Mm. These men are dead because of him. I said, stand down.
Well, you do have pink necks.
I just saved all your asses, so everyone just calm down.
Yep. That's right. Listen to me.
Lieutenant, what's going on here?
I made a bad call. This is all on me. I chose caution and clever tactics over a head-on attack. And my men paid the price.
What did you do?
You mean the crash?
Yes. We could see on Hollow that Reaper forces were blocking our intended path. Staying on course guaranteed heavy casualties. So I chose a safer route, skirting the enemy. And that took us low and through these ruins. When we encountered resistance, there was no room to maneuver. Suddenly, we were in a fight for our lives. A lot of my men lost that fight.
I see that. We've been seeing it. How many dead Turian have we seen? 5, 6? Bad calls happen. Can't really tell that to the families of these guys, but...
Owning your mistake takes guts, but you have to get over it and move on.
Of course. It's just fresh right now. Our mission's still a failure. When we've stabilized the injured, we'll head back to the fleet.
You're abandoning your mission?
We're down over 30 men. It'd be suicide.
What exactly did you come here to do?
There's a bomb on the planet. We were sent to defuse it.
A bomb? How big?
Enormous. Cerberus has it.
Oh, really?
Lieutenant, if Cerberus has that bomb, you have to finish your mission.
Yeah.
Haven't these men sacrificed enough?
I understand. This kind of sacrifice is the hardest to ask for, but your men signed on for it, and so did you.
That's true.
My men have lost hope, Commander. Even if I wanted to finish the mission, they don't.
It's your job to make them want to.
How?
Kick their asses! I kind of want to pick this option, but, appeal to their honor.
Their sacrifice means that others will never face what they faced here today. Remind them that those sacrifices have no honor if the mission fails.
Kick their asses.
Men,
one by one.
I own what happened here today.
Kick all the ass.
We have to carry on.
No, we don't. Who cares about a few dead Krogan? It's over.
We do.
Turian, and we will not let Cerberus succeed.
Or you do.
Our sacrifice is the difference between life and death for this entire galaxy. Let the heroes of the 9th Platoon,
be remembered for performing their duties with bravery. All right, men. Shuttle's arriving any minute. We're moving out.
Hmm. Just throw a speech at him and give him no time to argue.
Come with us.
Seems to have worked.
We're a shell of what we were. We could use the help.
Sure.
Send me the nav point. I'll see what I can do.
Thank you. That'll give us time to do a little recon. See what we're up against.
Victus, you have a second chance here. Make their sacrifice count.
Understood, Commander. Hope to see you at the rendezvous.
You know, we're gonna end up defusing this bomb, aren't we?
Cerberus bomb? What the hell is going on, Commander? And what do the Turians have to do with it?
Coordinates Victus gave me place it in the Kelphic Valley. It's a heavily populated area. That's all I know.
My gut says something's not right here.
What do you suggest?
Get the Primarch to come clean.
Should we alert the Krogan military?
I'd wait. We're in the dark here. Krogan-Turian relations are fragile until the genophage is cured. Let's not push it. And how about this bomb? How many troops does Cerberus have on this?
No idea. All I know is we can't have them detonating that bomb.
Keep me in the loop. Hack it out.
What would they be detonating it for? So we had to talk to Primarch, right?
Yeah. Impressive work on Tuchanka. I'm grateful that...
Why didn't you tell me about the Cerberus bomb? Why hide that? What else are you keeping from me?
Yeah, really?
I have nothing for you.
What?
For our alliance to work, I need to trust you.
Our friendship is new, Commander. Would you trust me with information that puts your people, puts Earth, at risk?
Interesting question. Poses a dilemma either way. Would I trust him with information? Not happily, but we have to trust each other, so I have to trust you. Earth should come first, but we have to work together.
Why would I jeopardize our alliance by lying to you now? It doesn't make sense.
Decisions like these weigh heavy on me. When I was a general, I could pass them up the chain of command. But now, I'm all I've got. Know what I mean?
Sure. And?
And that's all.
Huh.
Wait, there is one more thing, Commander. Thank you for saving my son.
Yep. Tuchanka bomb. The Turian team that crashed on Tuchanka was trying to prevent Cerberus from detonating a bomb that would cause massive casualties on the planet. Land on Tuchanka and help the Turian platoon stop Cerberus. Well, I think we're just going to go right into this. Anything else to say to him first? We got more Alliance funding, 12,500 credits.
I'm grateful for all you've done, Commander. The situation with the Krogan is already complicated enough.
Not as complicated as waking up one day and being told you're the new Primarch.
Yes, thank you. I'm beginning to understand why leaders so often seem lonely. Worst case scenarios aren't just theories. That which you'll be dealing with 5 minutes from now.
That's why it helps to have allies.
Yes, you're right, of course. Is there something I can help you with?
That's all.
Of course, Commander.
Let's look at our war assets and then we'll just head right to the next mission, the bomb. We've got new alien and new Turian. Shadow Broker Wet Squad. Now, the thing is, it's weird. Isn't Liara still a Shadow Broker? So wouldn't she tell us about this Wet Squad, not Barlavan? I don't know. Right. As the new Shadow Broker, Liara Tassoni has the loyalty of her predecessor's assassination squad, a small but lethal team of soldiers called on for the rare occasion when information isn't enough to silence a target. Their methods vary with each mission, from subtle poisonings to bombing entire buildings. The Wet Squad is dedicated to whatever range of destruction the new broker requires. Dr. Sassoni has put them to work against the Reapers and Cerberus. So I don't think we need Barlavan to give us the heads up. Why couldn't she find them? I mean, she's the Shadow Broker. She's supposed to know everything, right? I might have forgotten exactly the details. Dextro rations. When do we find this? When they were struck by the Reapers, the agribusinesses of Triginta, Petra, alright, previous system, had a surplus of both plant and animal-based food products for dextro amino acid-based sapients. Both Turian troops who favor a meat-heavy diet and the Quarians who are typically vegan show a marked preference for these recovered rations, suggesting that although they were wiped out by enemy forces, the Petrans had pretty good taste. Serving Petran food to a unit about to go into combat can restore a little morale and dignity to an otherwise demoralized squad. So it's still a 50%, but our total military strength is way past the minimum, and we're a little more than halfway of the, you know, the maximum. So that's how it appears. I could be wrong. I don't think there's going to be any updates for this little thing, so let's head to the next thing. We'll just check with Rex really quick.
What was that all about with the Primarch? Turian's up to something?
It's nothing. Don't worry about it.
Uh-huh. All right.
That's it for now, Rex. Let's get back to work.
Anytime.
Well, he had something to say.
I just figured you'd be more sympathetic to someone joining Cerberus. You've never been big on aliens.
Yeah, I enlisted to kick ass, just like everyone else. But I need a better reason than it has scales to go kill somebody.
Huh.
And if Cerberus
well sad.
Is taking our dishonorable discharges and Cat 6 washouts, it's just one more reason they're not worth a damn.
Cool. I agree. Anything to say?
You were right, Commander. It sounded like things were bad down there.
The Turians took some heavy losses, but we got them out okay.
Well, whatever you did down there stirred up a lot of Turian comm traffic.
What are they saying?
Sorry, it's encrypted. Cracking it would take at least a week, and it would be wrong.
Looked like she was hurting her neck the way she was turning her head all around like that. They have some new things to say, so let's run around and see. Why not, right?
So that went well. Glad to see that Turians can flip out and lose their shit just like the rest of us.
They're under a lot of pressure.
You stole the Normandy, got blown up by the Collectors, and sent us on a suicide mission at the Galactic Core. And I haven't mutinied once. Not once.
Your service is appreciated, Joker.
I am impressed by your continued existence, Joker.
Thanks.
The probability of surviving as long as you have is low.
Yeah, I call it save files.
Hello, Shepard.
Commander.
Yeah, I'm going to pop around and see on the other decks and see if anyone else has anything to say. Some pretty interesting conversations there that might be gone after I do the Cerberus bomb thing.
Everything okay, Shepard? Ma'am.
We can check out that armor we found.
Parts of Tuchanka reminded me of the desert back home. The lizards and worms are bigger, but, you know, the sand and everything. Primarch's son is in over his head, no? Hey.
Hey. Alright, let's check out the armor real quick. It was Hain Kadar or something or other. Well, I can't use anything with the Cerberus armor. Chest plate that feeds excess suit power to wearer's weapons. Oh, Or was it shoulders? No, it was chest. Okay, just want to take a look at it. At some point with all the add-ons, the N7 armor might become more powerful or useful than the Cerberus armor. We'll see.
Garen,
keep an eye on it.
Have you ever seen recordings of Liara's mother, Matriarch Benezia?
Mm. Yes, what about her?
Remember Samara, the Asari Justica?
Where are you going with this, Kenneth?
Have you noticed that older Asari women seem to be a bit more ample? Do you think they just keep growing?
Kenneth!
I think I'll spend my sunset days in an Asari retirement home.
Oh, God.
If I don't kill you first.
I think he just tries to make her jealous. And I also think it works.
Power grid is in the green.
Good to know.
Power grid is in the green.
Commander?
Commander.
Alright, we're done in here. Check in on Javik and Diana. He's awesome.
I heard about the events on Tuchanka. You should not have let the Turian soldier evade his responsibility.
Hmm.
I take it Protheans didn't forgive many mistakes?
They're pretty brutal.
If he had been under my command, I would have marooned him in the desert, buried him in sand up to his neck, and let the wildlife feast on his eyes.
Oh my God.
If he survived that, I would have rewarded him by shooting him in the head. Good soldiers are a precious resource. The stupidity of one cannot be allowed to jeopardize the lives of the others.
Huh. Wow.
The Turians are hiding something, Commander. Be careful.
There they are. And I'm wondering if it's something else that Victus isn't telling us? I guess if he's really holding back on us again, I gotta decide what to do with him.
Tuchanka was not always a wasteland. It once had jungles and forests.
Oh, they bombed the hell out of it.
The Krogan didn't need the Reapers to destroy their world. They did it on their own. Such a foolish race.
Very warlike. They don't seem to mind it that way, though.
I am with my own thoughts. I am with my own thoughts.
You're with your own thoughts. What are you working on here? Are you trying to build something with some rounds? Looks like a CD player or some kind of disc player? Wire? Notes? I don't know what the, some kind of cartridge is. You're making something in here? So interesting about Javik, he's very, very severe. And I'm wondering if that's
from Earth, off the radar, reaping begins in rural areas. Millions are dead in the Central Asian wilderness, even more in sub-Saharan Africa. We'll give you the gruesome view of what happens when the Reapers don't stop to indoctrinate. Now, in the battle space.
She doesn't seem to have that presence, that professionality. But I was saying about Javik, he's very harsh, very unforgiving, and I'm wondering if that's true of all of his race? I mean, obviously we only have him and the little glimpses we had of the other Protheans, I couldn't remember for a second, to really get an idea. I mean, maybe that's the average mentality of Protheans, or could be just him, they could be all individual, or obviously, or could be that's the soldier mentality. Either one, pretty interesting.
Commander.
Yeah, he's total unforgiving renegade with a lot of options, I'm sure. Crew deck, last one. Is the good doctor still in here?
Commander?
She's like not practicing medicine for a while because we haven't proceeded with the main quest. Alright. Who's where? I'm not even going to check on them. They don't have anything new to say every time I check. Sometimes Morden will be singing something. So I'll look in on them, but I'm not going to interact. Liara and Garrus. Let's just see if he says anything else. Idle chatter is what we're getting. Until we progress with the main quest.
Certainly possible. Would require strengthening exercises. Get muscles to support weaker bone structure.
Right. Yeah, I can do that.
Alloy of Edie's body not flexible like organic tissue could cause unintentional damage.
I've heard this before.
Pillows, cushions, possibly gel pads.
Okay, that's a little weirder, but yeah, alright, cushions.
Positioning critical to success. Can forward Edie charts, videos with relevant data.
No, let's Edie's pretty busy with, you know, stuff. Let's send that to me. You're not gonna tell anyone about this, right? Like Shepard? Shepard doesn't really need to know.
Ah. Guarantee Shepard won't learn about it from me.
She's standing right there, isn't she?
Yep.
I wish I wasn't.
I don't remember her saying that, but yeah, I was standing here the last four times as well. Let's check in on Garrus. Where'd it go? Wait. Liara and Garrus are in the lounge. What are those two up to? So I'll check in there anyway, too. In here. To look at the any new logs and stuff. Nothing new. Is there something else to check out? No, just those two, right? Yeah. For some reason, I thought I saw a third ring. So the lounge. Pardon me. Is here? Yes.
Enough about me. What were you doing before we met up here?
Oh, you know, this and that.
Come on, spill it to Sony.
Very well. I fought several explosive battles with Cerberus. I helped Shepard stop a robotic assassin on Mars. Oh, and I discovered plans for a Prothean doomsday device that were buried for 50,000 years.
Yeah, nothing much.
Yeah. So, just this and that, huh?
The guy's up to.
Hello, Shepard.
Oh, nothing to say, huh?
Turians on a secret mission to Tuchanka, huh? No one told me anything about it. I'm curious to see how this bomb on Tuchanka plays out.
Me too.
I don't suppose ignoring it is an option.
No. Then we go boom.
Another time, maybe.
Or they go boom. Yeah,
so,
you two don't...
Archangel.
You heard about that, huh?
Your sojourn on Omega generated quite a few articles, not to mention security footage. There's one thing I couldn't dig up, though. Did you really take out three Blue Sun's mercenaries with one bullet?
No, of course not. The third guy had a heart attack. It's not fair to count him.
Should I just stand around and see if they say anything else? I was walking away. Waiting to see if they say anything else. Anybody want a drink? It's on the house. You know what's so funny? Kinda looks like an old like floppy disk drive.
Another time.
Speak. Nothing else to say? Alright. Cause I only missed that, almost missed that one, right? Alright, this looks like a good time to cut it. Next episode. The bomb. The Tuchanka bomb. The Cerberus bomb. Tuchanka bomb. We'll be doing that. Thanks for watching. See you next time and endure. And enduring, grow strong.